2012.
Yeah.
The year that a lot of people thought would be the end of the world.
Yeah. Based on a 2009 movie.
Yeah, I know. And then nothing, and then it didn't happen, and then everyone was like, well, most people just went about their day, and it was like, that was...
I'm surprised there weren't riots.
Yeah,
saying,
I know.
You lied to us.
Yeah. Side note, the film 2012, the way it ends is friggin' terrible. Like, it doesn't even make any sense. If the whole world is ending, why does this certain thing that happens at the end of the movie, why is that still a thing?
Yeah.
I don't get it.
It's anyway. Like the world ends and then somehow comes back.
Yeah. The only thing that movie has going for it is, like, it was the hype around that time and the fact that maybe 2012 possibly slightly might have been the end of the world, though. And the effects were good, but otherwise I would say it was a pretty bad movie. I would say it wasn't very good of a movie. Yeah. Anyways, we're not talking about that movie. We're not talking about bad movies.
Yeah, we're getting way off topic.
Sorry. We're talking about our best films of 2012, and that was supposed to be like a little side note thing that went into a big tangent.
Yeah.
Anyways, what is your best film of 2012, Jake?
Well, for anyone who has a lust for learning but a dire hatred for school, I highly recommend seeing Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln has asked us to work with him to accomplish the death of slavery.
No one's ever been loved so much by the people. Don't waste that power.
This fight is for the United States of America.
Can we choose to be born, or are we fitted to the times we're born into?
Well, I don't know about myself. You may be.
Settles the fate for all coming time, not only of the millions now in bondage, but of unborn millions to come. Shall we stop this bleeding?
Yep. And in case you haven't really guessed what the story could be about, the title pretty much says it all. The president, Abraham Lincoln, and his fight to end slavery and the whole Civil War during the 19th century.
Yep. But the thing that they don't tell you is that Daniel Day-Lewis is Lincoln, this is a Steven Spielberg film, and this is a fantastic movie.
I mean, this was also another one of my favorite movie experiences, especially since when I was in American citizenship class, the teacher actually would have given us extra credit to see this movie and then quiz us on it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really good. I love when historical films come out and they can tie into whatever you're learning in the meantime. It's interesting. You know, it's interesting. It doesn't make you want to just, you know, like go to sleep on your desk.
Oh yeah. I mean, this one, I was not bored at all. I was awake throughout, mostly because of the acting and the writing.
Mm-hmm.
And just how it looked like they were actually in the 1860s during the Civil War time.
Oh my god, yeah. Cinematography was gorgeous too. Set design, all of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And honestly, I love that this does not feel like something you would see on the History Channel too, because if it was, I probably would just...
tuned in.
Locked out, or
just
not have liked it as much.
Change the channel. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, no, it feels so authentic to the time, and the performances are excellent. Daniel Day-Lewis is absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
I mean, this is one of Spielberg's best films as well. Sorry.
I mean, not only does he act well as Lincoln, but he looks and sounds like how we would picture Abraham Lincoln.
I feel like he completely becomes Abraham Lincoln. I did not see Daniel Day-Lewis at all. I saw Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah.
Nothing else.
Nope.
It was pretty amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
There's nothing I would change about this film, but then again, it's 12 nominations.
Mm-hmm.
Say it all, honestly.
They do.
And Spielberg was definitely the right person to direct this movie.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Big time. Big time. I wholeheartedly agree with that. Do you have a favorite moment for this movie?
Probably that now scene where Lincoln is trying to persuade everyone to end slavery. Where he's talking with the country's leaders.
Oh my god, that was a riveting scene.
Oh yeah.
That was so good. And it was just him talking, but it was so captivating.
Yeah,
I probably, if this was my favorite movie of this year, I would say that would also be my favorite moment.
Yeah, cool.
So good. So good. Anyway. Alrighty.
What is your pick for 2012?
Right, yeah, so Lincoln is an excellent film, and it was definitely in the running for best film of mine, but mine is J.A. Bayona's first English language film, which is technically his debut. I don't know if you can count The Orphanage. I believe that was a Spanish film.
Never seen it.
Okay, well, it's a horror film. This is The Impossible.
The most scary bit for me.
When the water hit.
When I came up, and I was all on my own. And then I saw the two of you. I didn't feel so scared anymore. If Mommy and Lucas are on their own right now, I'm gonna keep looking for them.
One love.
I'm scared.
One life.
I'm scared too.
And it's one need in the night. One life.
Thank you so much.
With each other. Sister.
Lucas. Brother. Good at it.
Agda Josef Morten.
You're looking for your family.
I'll look in all the hospitals and I'll look in all the shelters. I will find them, I promise you that.
Film completely drained me, but it drained me in a satisfying and gut-wrenchingly real way. This is the story of one family that had to survive when a tsunami hit Thailand in, I believe, 2004?
2004, yep.
Yeah.
It was considered the largest tsunami in the world and the second biggest earthquake overall.
Yep. Yeah, and from this movie's set design, to its performances, to its cinematography, to its absolutely haunting music, I love everything about this movie. First time I saw Tom Holland in a movie, he's absolutely incredible. You need to see it to believe it. Ewan McGregor, Naomi Watts, they all do a phenomenal job, especially with the material they were given, because it's not easy. Like, they had to go to some really... intense and dark places to be in this world.
I mean, it was based on a true story, and it honestly did actually feel more real than most natural disaster movies.
Yeah, it did. It was shockingly real, all the way up to like the injuries they suffered during the actual tsunami itself. It was horrifying. The way they captured the horror of the tsunami and how they had to get out of it and then survive after the aftermath was also super... painful as well.
Yeah.
But again, it felt like the movie totally earned it because they were treating this material and these people and these characters based off of real people with respect and honesty, and they weren't trying to sugarcoat anything.
No.
And
they were
just
being full frontal with this film. Like, yeah, this is a disaster movie. People are gonna die.
Yeah.
You're gonna see blood everywhere.
Well, yeah, it does, that's the other thing. It doesn't hold back, so you need to be prepared when you watch this movie, but if you're prepared, this movie was transformative for me. By the end of it, I was just a complete wreck, and I loved every minute of it. No, I'm not ashamed in saying that. When a movie reaches you in that way, you can tell that it was not only effective, but that it was a incredibly powerful experience. Yeah, my favorite part of The Impossible is when Tom Holland's character and his two younger brothers reunite with their dad, and then shortly after reunite with their mom. It's just, it just brings the waterworks, and it's an amazing scene.
Is there anything you would do differently with this film?
No.
No?
Nothing. I think it's told beautifully. This put J.A. Bayona, Juan Antonio Bayona, that's not how he goes as a director, this put him on the map for me, and he went on to make other films that I also love, but this was the starting point, and I just love this film so much.
Yeah.
I think that's really all I have to say, and I think I already said the favorite moment. You said the favorite moment.
Yep.
Lincoln is your favorite film of 2012.
Yours is The Impossible.
And mine's The Impossible. And we're now going to talk about our best
films.
I
feel like that's like a complete saying, Lincoln The Impossible.
Yeah, that's good. I didn't, that kind of totally came out of nowhere. You totally caught me off guard.
Yeah.
That's good, yeah. Yeah. Well done.
Yeah, thank you.
We're going to talk about our best films of 2013
Yep.
next.